The first value that we are looking at is blood hemoglobin level. 217 hemoglobin is significantly higher than normal. MCV is a little bit lower than normal, but because there is no anemia, it's not that important here. Usually, when hemoglobin is elevated, red blood cell count is elevated. And 8.14 red blood cells is a huge number. And also, the higher the red blood cell count, the higher the hematocrit. The next value is platelets. Platelets are 871, which is significantly higher than normal. So for now, we have very high hemoglobin level, red blood cell count, and hematocrit. Also, we have elevated platelet count. The next value that we are looking at are white blood cells. As we see, white blood cell count is 15.6, which is a little bit elevated. So now we have to determine due to which cells we have elevated white blood cell count. And there are three major possibilities. White blood cells consist of three major groups of cells. It's myelocytes, lymphocytes, and blood cells. Myelocytes consist of monocytes, basophils, eosinophils, and neutrophils. So now we have to exclude cells one by one, and by this we have to determine which cells can cause increase in white blood cell count. The first cells that we are looking at are blast cells, because in normal state there are no blast cells in peripheral blood. And in this case, there is no blast cells in peripheral blood, which is perfectly normal. So now two possibilities left, it's lymphocytes or myelocytes. The next value is lymphocytes. Lymphocytes in this case consist 17% of all white blood cells, which is a little bit lower than normal. So myelocytes left. First of all, we are looking at neutrophils. We see that the percentage of segmented neutrophils is normal. Bands a little bit elevated, and there is no metamyelocytes and myelocytes, which is normal. The total amount of neutrophils here is 73% of all white blood cells. So white blood cells, in this case, consist of 73% of neutrophils and 17% of lymphocytes. Eosinophils and basophils are within normal range, and also monocytes are normal. So in this case, because there is no blood cells and lymphocytes a little bit lower than normal, we can say that white blood cells are a little bit elevated due to the myelocytes, primarily due to the neutrophils. And increase in blood hemoglobin level for female higher than 160, with increase in hematocrit higher than 48%, in combination with increase in platelets, which is also can be accompanied by increase in white blood cells, is the diagnostic criteria for polycythemia vera. Also, we can measure erythropoietin level, which in this case should be low, and to confirm the diagnosis, we have to determine the presence of JAK2V617F kinase, which is mutated JAK2 kinase with phenylalanine in 617 position instead of valine.